Hello, and welcome back to Dark Souls. Just finished up the Undead Asylum, so let's get out of here. Aw, man. I was hoping I would be able to look cool and, like, slash this guy and immediately just go slash, slash, and they'd be right there. That would have made me look cool. Given me some street cred, I think. But I guess we'll just pay it back. Go ahead, set me on fire. See what I care. I don't. Because I'm better than you. Alright, actually, I lied. There's one more thing you can do here. And that thing is over here, on this ledge. If you go to this crow's nest and curl up like a ball, no. If you come over here, hello? Hello? Alright, I'm gonna do something here. I'm gonna drop some rubbish in this nest. And then I'm gonna quit the game. Now you may be yourself. What's he doing? Why do you drop some rubbish and then leave the game? Well, hopefully you'll be able to find out. Yep.
You give me warm, give me soft.
This nest has an invisible crow in it. And that crow wants warm, soft stuff. So we gave it our trash. And it gave us a titanite chunk. Very fair trade. Titanite chunks are used to upgrade weapons from levels 10 to 14. And they're useful. So there's a bunch of other stuff you can trade to that crow. For instance, fire bombs, black fire bombs. It says give me warm. Well, these are obviously warm. I believe you can give it an egg vermifuge. I think humanities as well. If you give it, it gives you stuff back. And I think there are a few pieces of equipment you can give it, but I don't know the chart. Luckily, we don't have to wait 15 seconds or however long it was the first time with Pro. It just comes immediately and picks us up. And we're headed back to Firelink. And from Firelink, I think I'm gonna torture myself. And you'll see what I mean. In just a second. First off, let's get down off this place. You wanna be careful. If you die, you're gonna be back at the Undead Asylum. And you'll have to kill all those torch hollows, and you'll have to climb back up the cliff, and you'll have to curl up like a ball again and watch the cutscene. So just don't die climbing down there, please. It's not pleasant. You know? No, I won't do that. So what I am gonna do, though, as I said, I'm gonna torture myself. Hey there, Lautrec. I forgot, you never gave us my reward.
Hello there.
Gave us my
reward. Please, accept it.
Thank you.
I am grateful to you for freeing me. Not enough for you. Well, let's not be greedy now.
So, it's pretty obvious he's giving off some shady vibes, but I'm just gonna let him be. I trust him. He was just locked up in a cage in a boarded up room in a abandoned church. You know, I'm sure he's on the up and up. So we're gonna head down this way. And down this way, if you remember from my first or second video, down here is, like, I pointed myself in this direction and said down here is the new Londo ruins. And we're not going to be going into this area. We're just going to be skirting around the edges of it. All these hollows here are passive. They're not going to attack you unless you attack them first. And they give a meager amount of souls, so really it's not even worth it. And if you're having trouble getting through Undeadburg, trying to get to Andre, trying to upgrade your weapon, never fear. There's a blacksmith right here.
Hmm? Well, this is unusual. You haven't lost your head. And more importantly, you're free. How on earth? Well, I shouldn't pry. I'm Rickett of Vinheim. I was once an established smith, but look at me now. Can you believe it?
Maybe. I don't really know anything about you. Maybe you deserve being locked up.
What is it? Have you? Oh, no. Don't worry. I've no intention of escape. It's safe here. I can't bear the thought of going hollow out there. Although, I must admit, I've not much to occupy myself. How about this? I could forge your weapons, albeit with rather minimal tools. I'll show you what made me the best in Vinheim.
Yeah, so this guy can reinforce your equipment, or upgrade your equipment, and repair it. Let's just do that real quick. There. So yeah, if you're having trouble getting through Undeadburg, or the first part of the Undead Parish, well, you can come see this guy. Upgrade your weapon, get a little more offensive ability.
Goodbye then. Keep your head on it. You really helped break the monotony.
Aw, that's sweet. But that's not why we came down here. Why we came down here is so we could come up this tower. And this tower, I don't have the key for. But since I have the master key, I'm able to come out here into the Valley of the Drakes. And from here, you'll see why this is torture. This tunnel leads to the second half of Blighttown. If I just go through this tunnel, I'd be able to skip the entire top half of Blighttown. But I said I wouldn't do that, so I'm not gonna do that. I'm gonna go back down the depths, and enter Blighttown from the top, and work my way down. Now do you see why it's torture? Maybe if you've never played this game, you don't see why that's torture yet. You will. How's that? Does that get you hyped for Blighttown? Going through it's torturous. Alright, well, let's get back up here. Altric? Still hanging out?
By the Lord. Your face.
Yeah. I'm
your
jerky.
Humanity is really slipping, but there are methods. Most fools have more humanity than they know what to do with. Now, who do you imagine will make the best use of it?
So you're saying I should kill people for their humanity? Why don't I start with you, Lautric? Just kidding. Alright. Depths, Blighttown, let's go. And hopefully I'll just be able to run past these guys without any incident. You should. Yep, so far so good. Perfect. Still gonna kill the rat. No humanity. That's why you kill the rat. it can give you humanity. And it's just a nice little boost. So, on this run back, I really don't have anything to talk about. How's that, huh? Riveting, right? I don't have anything to talk about, so I'm not going to talk about anything. Deal with it. And now I'm kind of committed to this joke of me not saying anything this entire time. But I feel like that might not be received very well. So, here's a little shortcut. You just hop straight down here. So, let's see. What can I talk about? I don't know. Oh, by the way. If you remember, last time we came through this area, we were... What the heck? What are you... What? What? These guys, they don't know what they're doing. Anyway, last time we came through this area, we were slogging around, you know, walking super slowly, getting... Now we're running about. Well, that's the benefit of the Rusted Iron Ring.
The Rusted Iron Ring.
If I remove that... Ugh. This is my run. What was it on? Haha! So there you go. There's a little sample of what's... What the heck? Did you guys just like... Yeah, you all just dropped down here, huh? Man. You too, huh? I try to let you guys live, and what do? You make me kill you. Pitiful. Let's see if I can bait this guy. Up. Yeah. You wouldn't be able to do that without the ring. Just be aware. If you tried to do that without having this ring equipped, this guy would drop on you and do some damage. Oh, what the heck? Hollows. Hollows everywhere. And not a drop to drink. That reference doesn't make any sense. Alright. Can I actually run through here, please? Alright. Oh, so close. Get off me. You can hear me frantically pressing buttons. That actually does help when...
I can't find the answer to the question I heard.
That actually? Is that what just triggered you? No, I think it was actually does. Finding out all kinds of stuff about the Echo. Alright. What was I even saying? I got so distracted by the little ring of light that came up. Oh yeah. Frantically mashing buttons. I was... Well, frantically pressing the... L1, L2, or LB, LR buttons, and that actually does help you get out of grabs or, you know, stuff like that. It helps you get out of it quicker, so you don't take as much damage. I don't think I want to buy anything. Old pine resin, crystal stuff, arrows, maybe some arrows. Yeah. Let's get 70. Those will come in handy for separating groups of enemies.
Fine trade. I have this funny feeling we'll meet again soon. You'll make another fine trade, of course.
This guy's just cheery. Alright. So here we go, Blighttown. Do not just drop here. I don't know if that's obvious or not, but don't do it. It's not a smart idea. Instead, just take this ladder. You know, it might not be as fun, but you won't die in the process. And here we go, just like I was talking about. I don't think there's a torch up there, but here's a torch attached to a ladder. And that is a common theme in Blighttown, because it's dark, it's confusing, so you need some kind of guides. Here we have an ogreman. So let's climb up here. And I think we're gonna just drop on him. And not do a plunging attack, because who would want to do that? So I'm actually learning. You can't just hold R1 or RB as you're going off a ledge. You actually have to press it while you're in the air. Because I've been like, when I was right here, as I stepped forward, I pressed and held down RB. But I bet if I wait just a second, yeah, I almost kill myself. I don't know why my voice is cracking so much. I'm sure that's fun to listen to. Alright. Here we go. Come at me. Slam. Alright, awesome. I can kill these guys in one stamina bar. And they drop dung pies. Well, it's right here. Dung pie is atrocious fecal waste matter. You throw it at enemies to build up toxins, but also builds up your toxicity. Now actually, something that was found out in this area, there are people that give you toxic, and toxic is like poison, but a lot worse. It reduces your health quicker. And the toxin that the guys in here give you is really powerful. Like, if you get hit by it and you don't have any... Well, I don't have any. But if you don't have any blooming purple moss clumps... See, purple moss clump just reduces poison. Blooming purple reduces toxin, or gets rid of toxin. If you don't have any of those and you're out of Estus, you're just dead. But the toxic you get from dung pies is actually less effective than the toxic you get from those guys. I'm not doing any gameplay, I'm just explaining this. So if you find yourself just, you're always getting hit by those guys, they're always applying their toxic to you, then consider maybe giving toxic to yourself, but at a much weaker degree, and you might be able to make it. Because once you're toxic, you can't be retoxicked. Toxicked? Toxicked. Triggered the echo. That makes no sense. Doesn't even sound like the name that shall not be named. Alright, so here are these guys. They're something. I don't know what they are. But they're no big deal, really. Just don't let them gang up on you, like most enemies. Alright, can you hear that? That's a guy shooting toxic blow darts. And when I went in the depths, I picked up this spider shield. This spider shield has resistance to poison, aka completely blocks it. So if you just hold this up, see, there he is, he's shooting the toxin darts at me. But the spider shield completely negates it. Oh, and there's a guy coming. Unfortunately, I don't think this shield has 100% physical damage reduction. Well, let me check that. I don't want to just say things and be wrong. No, it does. So I was wrong. Alright, so yeah, this shield completely stops the toxin. So it's a good shield to have in this area. Because then you can fearlessly approach these guys, kill them. He gave me some room for- Ah! Alright. So. Toxic guys do not respawn. So once you kill them once, they're dead forever. Okay. I dropped. No biggie. So yeah, once you kill toxic guys, they're dead for good. You don't have to worry about them anymore. Which is just a little bit, the tiniest bit of mercy that FromSoft shows its players. So I mean, that's just the beginning of Blighttown. Like, we haven't even really gotten into it yet. We've just come down a couple ladders and walked down this path. I believe, is this a jump? Yeah, there's a jump right here. I heard you coming at me. Try jumping off. For once, and maybe the only time, that is actually a useful hint. So let's try jumping off. And jump! Made it. We got the Iaito. And a view of the bonfire. Iaito is it's an inferior katana to the one we have right now. But if you're against killing merchants for some odd reason, you can get this one. But with the bonfire just right in front of us, I want to be careful where I drop. I don't know where I can... Right here? Yeah, right here. Not there. Just here. Thing behind me. A ladder is behind me. Is there a guy climbing up the ladder? No. Alright. So here we go. First bonfire of Blighttown. And what do I need? 1,000? Yeah, I'll level up once. Soul? Yeah, perfect. And we'll go Vitality. Just bring everything up to 20. And by everything, I mean my three important stats. Vitality, Endurance, Dexterity. Alright, and that's where I'm going to leave this off. So, thank you for watching. If you enjoyed the video, hit like. If you like my commentary, my gameplay, hit subscribe. And I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching.